لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، ما لنا رب سوى.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده. أجمل منك لم تر قط عيني، وأحسن منك لم تلد النساء، خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب، كأنك خلقت كما تشاء. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على أشرف الخلق وحبيب الحق المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, respective viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا and welcome to our program. First of all, let us make dua to Allah. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless those who are newly married, and may Allah grant them peace, may Allah grant them rizq, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them as-salih children, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease the way of those who want to marry and fulfill the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah fill their life with barakah and nur inshallah. Brother and sister in Islam, we welcome you again. Shukran jazeelan for your comment and your feedback on behalf of all our friends here. Shukran jazeelan for watching ITV and our program. On behalf of each and everyone here in Johannesburg studio, Brother Farhad Omar, Brother Imtiaz, and all our friends here behind the camera, we say shukran jazeelan that you use our ITV as a madrasa. May Allah reward all our ulama and our brothers who are participating and feeding the ummah with the knowledge of Allah and the sunnah of his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Well, again, I have to remind you that our program here is not a fatwa program, it's a da'wah program. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us to spread the kalima of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This week, I received so many calls regarding two things, dreams and jinn. And when we talk about these two topics, it's very interesting to talk about that, and you know, it's very lovely show to talk about jinn and weather, jinn and all that. And about the dreams, you know how many, especially our South African viewers and some our neighboring countries, they so excited to know about the dreams, and especially those who made istikhara, and they want to know the result of istikhara and something like that. I don't know, that jinn is running after me all over. When we go to the Friday Jum'ah khutbah and day on our madrasa or wherever we go, you find the people, my friend is running after me, want to convince me that he got a jinn. And there are some talking people in his head, and he want to me to come and break that jinn and to solve that problem. Brother and sister in Islam, again and again and again, we have to repeat again and again and again. We have seen life, we have unseen life. This surah in Quran is called Suratul Jinn. We do believe that there is jinn, but we do believe that there is Allah and His Sharia and the Iman and the Aqidah of Allah. So we don't want to deny that there is no jinn, but we don't want to terrorize people that there are some powerful creature of Allah can change the written taqdeer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we should not put that issue of jinn bigger than what it's supposed to be. If Quran did not talk about jinn, we would not never talk about it at all. Unseen life, we have to believe on it. Seen life, we have to work on it. Brother and sister in Islam, what you want to do with jinn, that invisible creation of Allah? You have viruses in your body. What to do? You take some injection, you try to prevent yourself not to be infected by the virus. You got a flu and influenza, and we got so many viruses around us. Brother and sister in Islam, if that person infected by jinn, who is scared of jinn or something like that, we, a Muslim, believe that above the power of jinn, the creator of jinn is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let me convince our mothers and our ladies and our sisters that if you make the issue of jinn bigger than the taqdeer of Allah, you're associating partner with Allah, you make shirk. Because Allah, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, the Lord of the world. So we don't have other power beside the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jinn is shaitan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna kayda shaitani kana da'ifa. Indeed, the plan of shaitan is so weak. It's so weak. Right. The problem is not the jinn. The problem that you are weak. You don't know how to stand. You don't want to how to defend and prevent yourself from that. The lady came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, inni usra. Ya Rasulullah, I fat on the street. I just fall on the street. And then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, In shi'ti, if you wish, I can make dua for you. Wa in shi'ti sabarti wa lakil jannah. And you can take the other option. You just hold, wait. Don't discuss that issue. Just hold. And I will guarantee for you Jannah. You know why? Because Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't want to stretch that issue of fitting jinnat in the body and all that. Why? Because it's simple. It's not so heavy. Now, the lady came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, walakinni atakashraf. But my body is exposed. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, now we can make dua. Oh Allah, cover her body. The lady used to fit on the street, but her body is covered. So the lady was worried about hijab more than to take out the jinn or to see what is inside her body. Brother and sister in Islam, jinn is a creature of Allah. Same like any viruses or any infection, have a prevention, make tawakkul Allah. And as I said many times, our dangerous jinn is the children of Adam, me and you. This is a proper jinn. Why? Because we never see the jinn breaks the bank and make a civil war on what is happening in Syria or in any part of the world. We never see there was a civil war between jinn and human being or jinn and jinn. It was men like me and you causing corruption on earth, making facade and causing a big problem and take the life of the innocent children and people. Brother and sister in Islam, unseen life, we believe in it. But you have no permission from Allah to go and dig down and find out the jinn because it is da'if. The existence of jinn is da'if, is very weak. And the plan of jinn and plotting of jinn also is very weak. Many people say, no, I saw plague cat passing or plague dog passing. I don't know why they say plague. But they say it's a jinn. Wallahi al-azim, even if it's a jinn, but now in this moment, when that cat passed here, it is cat. It is cat. He killed this cat, the jinn died. So when Allah gives the jinn that power to form itself on certain things, the nature, the law of the nature of that creature will run on that type of animal or whatever. If the jinn made itself as a pen, and one child come and break the pen, the jinn died, can't go back to invisible forms. That's why inna kayda shaitani kana da'ifa. Let us fight the main jinn, that evil of insan, the kufr of insan, hypocrisy of insan. Let us come to be realistic and deal on the ground. Leave the invisible life to the invisible Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to deal with it. That's why we say قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. I seek protection in the Lord of mankind. We never say, I seek protection in this man or that person. I need the invisible power because jinn is invisible. So we need invisible power to protect us. Who's that one? Allah is Qudrat and Allah is power. Brother and sister in Islam, let's come back on the ground to see. The other thing about the dream. How many times we spoke about dream? That dream is a dream. You cannot set up Sharia and Islamic law because someone was dreaming. We cannot accuse someone because of his dream because the malaika don't write that what the sleeping person doing. If you make kufr while sleeping or you divorce your wife, it won't be counted. Sleeping is sleeping. Now the person said, I slept, that there's a snake there or the fire in my house, like that. We tell him very simple and easy. Take it easy. If you have good dream, make shukr to Allah and wish that it will happen. If you have a bad dream, it should not irritate you at all and say, no, I'm not Ibrahim alayhi salam to see the proper dream. I'm not pious enough to see the good dream. And also anyone who interpreted the dream is not a proper Yusuf alayhi salam to interpret the ta'wil al-ahadith. So take it easy. If you dream this or that, say a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim, because we have three type of dreams. We have ru'ya. Ru'ya, it means portion of prophecy, which you people claim that you have it. And we have another one, it's called hulm. The hulm, it means the shaytan one. And we have adghath wa ahlam, that punch of that, they call it psychological dream, the psychological dream, that punch of the daily action. Ru'ya, it's part of prophecy. Very few people got it, very few. And Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam, he did not take it as a sureness and as guarantee. He said, وَقَالَ لِلَّذِي ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ نَاجِمٌ, he thought that maybe he will be saved from the jail. Brother and sister Islam, we are the people of reality. A'mal, action. In the day of Qiyamah, Allah will judge you according to your action, not according to your dream. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a good dream in our reality to be a good Muslim, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister Islam. And once again, we thank you that you tune into our program. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah rabbul izzat tabarak wa ta'ala ease our way to practice the teaching of Quran. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah guide us imanul uqul, the belief of our brain, the belief of our heart, so that we can practice the deen of Islam with yaqeen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before the break, I was talking about those who are trying to raise the issue of jinn and that issue of unseen life. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant me and you that realistic belief, the belief which in the ground, the belief which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will question me and He will reward me because of my a'mal. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Don't forget your hisab after you believe in Allah and His Rasul. It will be about your action. And you say action speaks louder. And of course, action will be rewarded more than the words in the day of Qiyamah. The other thing which I want to discuss it with you tonight, that what's wrong with a Muslim when he run behind the superstition and he doesn't want to follow the sunnah and the sharia. Because insan like me and you, we have nafs, we have some thought of nafs, that type of creation of Allah, they call it I, or that type of desire in ourselves. That self or that nafs, it's a mystery. It's a mystery. Nafs been mentioned in the Quran about 115 times. That nafs which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about it in so many hadith, and that nafs causing a problem for me and you, and may Allah save us, let the 80 years old man die without iman. So be, instead of discussing jinn and that thing, let us talk about our nafs and ourself, how to maintain your nafs to be the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The worst enemy ever you have in yourself, it's called that nafs or that I. It's a transportation of shaitan. It is the motivation for good or bad. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَهَا. Brother and sister in Islam, nafs taking that natural desire which we have in our body, sexual desire, that food desire, knowledge desire, or any type of desire, and let you misuse it. Not only that, they make tazyin. What is this tazyin? Beautify the haram till that nafs enjoy that haram and can die for that haram. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Sayyidina Jabir ibn Abdullah mentioned in the hadith that narrated on Sahih, a Muslim and Tirmidhi, that Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم described himself and those who call people to Hidayah, the ulama, the scholars, the parents, that all those people who try to help us to be guided, he said, my example as a prophet and the example of the followers and the people around me as the person set up fire in a desert at night, fi falat. And in janadub and farash, that butterflies, locusts, the insects saw the fire. But because they don't have enough knowledge about this fire, they thought is a noor, is a light. And that person, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, came and he tried to prevent and stop that insects from coming inside the fire. And he said, while I'm taking you from your belt, and try to pull you away from the fire, but he said, but tuflituna minni, and you escape between my hands. That hadith is very simple hadith, but we learn a lot from it. Number one, shahwa, the desire, the enjoyment, has some sort of taste, very attractive. Who made it attractive? Not because the shahwa is attractive, because our thought, our concept, our desire, our nafs made it beautiful. Not every beautiful thing comes in your mind, it means it's good, or it is okay, or it's beneficial. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, dhubab, farash, the mosquitoes, butterflies, and locusts, and small insects, they come. But the lion, when he sees the fire, he runs away. He knows what the difference between light, nur, and fire. But that insects, you know. The interesting thing in this hadith, he said that insects or the butterflies, they saw their friends is falling in the fire and burning there, but blindly they follow them. And you see around your light or your globe, so many insects burn there, but the other one also, they come. They never learn from the problem of the others. It shows that those people who come to haram, they don't think properly. They are not wise. They don't work it out according the benefit or the harming for themselves. Brother and sister in Islam, do not be butterfly. Be the lion. Be the wise creation of Allah, knows what is. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, but some of you flee between my hand and goes to the fire. Anyone who call people to morality, people don't like him. Anyone who try to give order and to instruct people to do good, amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy an munkar, they call him terrorist, radical, they give him a name. But unfortunately, the enemy of Islam, they try to switch on the fire and don't want anyone to stop the butterfly going to the fire. They say homosexuality, they say, oh, it's like that. When you talk about this or that, you say, no, let the people enjoy. He said, no, our deen is to hold you back from the fire and to save you from the fire. And Nabi Muhammad ﷺ did say that around Jannah, there is makareh, there is command. So people don't want to go to Jannah because they are bound to the day of command of Allah. And surrounding Jahannam, that attraction, shahawat, that desire. Brother and sister in Islam, let us think again. How can we adjust our desire? How can we use the desire as ibadah, not as a means to destroy me and you? Nafs, that desire, or that motivation cause you to do haram, it's your own enemy. And plus, a'da, it's a serious fight. It's the serious fight ever you face in your life, that when you fight your desire and to adjust it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you defeated your desire and you put your desire under control, you became Abdullah. You become a true slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other thing, that nafs, Allah didn't leave it free like that. Allah adjust it and put the command and teach me and you how to put it. You must not oppress it so hard, so it will cause, it will have a stress and then you commit a suicide. And then don't open the door for that desire and you become worse than the animals. And then you become on that person who's running for lust and desire, and you become more than the animals. Islam came to put it on its place. We marry, we work, we sleep, we have a holiday, we work, we worship Allah, we have family, we are human, and we are servant of Allah. We know how to adjust our feeling and our desire under the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Those who are fortunate, the one who purify and adapt the beauty of this nafs. How many people had a bad habit? And by the tazkiyat of Quran, by the dua, by the effort and striving, they became salihin. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you implement that type of habit in your body, haram habit, that you will die with it. And then when the command of Allah comes, and your desire resists on it, you will be punished in the time of death with taqleebul qalb. Allah will turn your heart in the time of sakaratul maut. Brother and sister in Islam, many people could not control their desire. Many people lost dunya and akhirah because of a simple desire he would have adjusted. Music is desire. Bad habits, smoking, drugs is desire. Zina is desire. Homosexuality is desire. Lying is desire. Bad habit. This type of desire, if that desire control you, you're no more slave of Allah. أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَى. Have you not seen the one who took his own desire as God? Yes, he take his desire as God. When Allah call you for something and your desire call you for something else, who you are? You're obeying who? You know what the meaning of slave? Obedience, you obey. So Allah said, حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ. Come here for salah, and then you go for this movie or whatever day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِن لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُ لَكْ. If they don't respond to the call of Islam, فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّمَا يَتَّبِعُونَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. Be informed that they are following their own desire. You know that some people don't want to accept Islam because of that desire. Don't want to change his habit. Ummatul Islam, Imam al-Ghazali, he wrote a kitab, it's called Amrad al-Qulub, the sickness of the heart, which is based on desire. When you have Amrad al-Qulub, you know the sick person, always Allah helped him and feel sorry for him. But what about the one who got sickness in his manner and his attitude and his behavior? Allah punish him, not to give him excuse. Ummatul Islam, many people say, I want to do. First favor you do it for yourself. Just control your desire and become a slave of Allah. And then now you come help the others. Inshallah, after the break, I will tell you how to overpower your desire and how to defeat your desire, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us that opportunity to be with you and to be part of your family today. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah ease our way to practice Islam and to enjoy that practice. And may Allah reward all of us for that great effort and that striving to fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How to defeat your nafs and your desire. How to put it back on its shape and make it under control. Number one, knowledge. You must know what I'm telling you now. You have to have enough knowledge about you. You are the body and ruh and nafs. So you must know what type of nafs you have and how can you maintain that nafs. So knowledge. Learn more about. And we recommend for you the kitab of Imam al-Ghazali. It's called Amrad al-Qulub. He got that kitab, is very good, discussing each and every sickness of desire in a human body. The other thing also, they call it muraqabah, maintain your heart. The problem is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after we commit a sin, he makes some blockage between our heart and our intention. Many people want to change. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ. Be informed that Allah put the gap between the person and his willpower in his heart. Many people want to change the habit, like those who are addicted to drugs. He really wants to change. But this person doesn't know how to get rid of that. And he said, no, I'm already in. He said, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never put you through this situation without giving you the exit. There is exit, how to make islah al-qalb, how to pull that desire from your heart. The other thing also, if you want to know how to stop that desire, you must know the value of Allah and who's Allah. You must know more about Allah. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. You don't give a proper value to Allah. If you know how serious is that issue, when you do not know Allah and you disobey Allah because you do not know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you know how much punishment waiting for the person and how powerful is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will stop that. You will have that power and that energy. The other thing also, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent 23 years to teach me and you how to purify our nafs, how to elevate that nafs and take it from nafsul ammaratum bisu' to nafsul mutma'inna. Ya ayatuha nafsul mutma'inna, we call it jihadun nafs. Training. Build up your nafs in iman. It's like a small child, the way you brought him up. The other thing also, how to make dhikrullah, so that you can get your heart back. You know that gap? That ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'innu al-qulub. How to make a specific dhikr to bring your heart closer to Allah and to have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other thing also, we call it collective ibadah. Make the salah in congregation. Try to make, do not worship Allah alone. Join some people. Barakallahu fil jama'a, yadullahi ma'al jama'a. Make your ibadah collectively with the people. Definitely you will have some effect from the salihin around you. The other thing also, which is very important, change the environment. Our environment, our society gives us that sickness. Because once your friend like this, so the society accept that, you need to leave, you need to migrate from that. The other thing is called sabr and musabara and murabata. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu isbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu. Make sabr and then become determined, extend that sabr and get used to make sabr. Unfortunately, some people, they make sabr sometimes. No, you have it. It must be part of your qualities and by your personality. Brother and sister in Islam, you are not the first one who tried to change himself. You find people who are worse than you and I, they change. Sahaba, they were idol worshiper for so many years. They used to drink, they used to that, but immediately when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them hidayah, they mean it and they change and they had nafsul kafira, now they have nafsul radiya al mardiya. Ya ayyatuha nafsul mutma'inna, irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiya. They became nafs with a peaceful nafs with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other thing, why we have the stress? Why we have depression? We have anxiety. Why we are unstable? We are moody. Because we have failure to adjust the three horses. Body, soul, nafs, the desire. Body needs something. Soul needs something else. Nafs needs something else. So three horses pulling. They don't run on the main way. And then we want to live to satisfy our desire. And we want to live to satisfy Allah and the society. And you say you're acting so many character in one day. You want to be a salih, and you want to be naughty, and you want to be shaitan, you want to be malaika. You say impossible. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent anbiya, thousands of anbiya, to let us adjust that three portion and to become a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, is the descendings of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, when we talk about this man, we did not fulfill the right of that person. He was a saint of Allah, the wali of Allah. And despite that some group of Muslims, they make him a god or whatever they, I'm talking about Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, how to deal with Ahl al-Bayt, the descendings of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They have the fragrance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They have the spark of Nubuwa in their body. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq kana a'lamu an-nas bi asrari Allah fil Quran. He was the most learned person, the one who knows The secret of Allah in the words of Quran. You know, the kitab of Allah, وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. We have revealed from the Quran the cure and the mercy for the believer. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, he said, insan in this world needs four things. Once he obtained and gained that four things, so he's secure and he can gain nafsul mutma'inna, radiya mardiya. He said that plotting, makr, those people who made a bad plan against us. You are working in a company, so you find someone is running after you and try to throw you away from your job or whatever. They call it makr. Makr, it means that grass softly and gently surrounding the tree and kill the tree. So not everyone loves you. We have enemy in our life. And unfortunately, that makr, or that plotting, or that evil planning behind you is very bad and is very common nowadays. He said, I'm wondering about those who fears that plotting, that makr, that evil, those people who made it at night. And he did not run and make dua to Allah. وَأُفَوِّضُ أَمْرِ إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. He said, once you read this dua and you understand this dua about those who make qaid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn their plan for you, not against you. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a plan for Yusuf alayhi salam to be the prime minister of Egypt, وَكَذَلِكَ كِدْنَا لِيُوسُفِ. We have made that plotting for the favor of Yusuf alayhi salam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, just say, وَأُفَوِّضُ أَمْرِ إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. Once you believe on that, you'll see your nafs stable. You have no stress and you have no worry. You just hand it, they say, I leave it for Allah. I give the case in the hand of my lawyer. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq said, I'm wondering about those who got fear, those who are frightened of something. In our time now, there is some thought of a mass disease. The media gave it to us. The enemy of Islam gave it to us. It's called the culture of fear. People make us scared. Bird flu, swine flu, a crisis of food, crisis of water. In news now, when you watch the news now, it's like you're reading the funeral page. So horrible news, you get stressed. There's no positive news. All day, this man died here, been killed like that. You give you a lot of stress. Some of my friends, they say, we don't watch the news because they give us such a stressful moment. They said, you be careful of that mood or that atmosphere of fear, because Muslim only fear Allah. And he knows that Allah will make a plan. Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq said, when you have that fear in you, just say, حَسْبُنَاللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change that fear to favor. No harm will come to them. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. What a powerful word when the servant of Allah meant it when he said it. The other thing, Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, he said, I'm wondering about those who got stress. قل اغتم غم. You know what is اغتم? Coming calamity, and is a horrible calamity on the way to you. The person got cancer, the person got a heavy calamity of Allah, and he doesn't know how to get rid of it or how to take it. Brother and sister in Islam, that stress is not more than the stress of Nabi Yunus alayhi salam while he's in the stomach of the whale. Can you believe that Nabi or that man can come out from the stomach of the whale in the stomach of the ocean? فَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمْ وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Ummatul Islam, if you have the stress, think about Nabi Yunus alayhi salam. These doctors say it's a hopeless case, cancer will kill you, you are this and that. Say, doctor is not God. Doctor, read from the book, but Allah, الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم, he knows how to see. And we see in our life how many stressful situations came and people get the ease and get the solution من حيث لا تحتسب. So they said, let's say for that غم, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. The dua of Nabi Yusuf, Yunus عليه السلام. Brother and sister Islam, why we are shouting people they don't go for the fortune teller? Because he will give me 1,000 good news and 1 bad news. That bad news will give me gham, the future one. You say, why you give me the news in advance? Wait till it happened. Why you bring for me negative news before? Don't read your future. Leave it, we'll take it from there. So just say, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. سيدنا جعفر الصادق said, I want to tell those who want dunya and want to live in this dunya in a beautiful way, just say, ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. It will guarantee the ni'ma in your hand and will bring the ni'ma from Allah سبحانه وتعالى's hand. Brother and sister in Islam, وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. That is your need, that is your demand, that is your security in your life in this world. Short break, we'll continue after the break inshallah.
لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister Islam. And once again, we thank you that you're tuning to our channel. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant us peace in this world and peace in the grave and peace in the day of judgment, inshallah. Allahumma innaka anta salam wa minka wa alayka salam wa ilayka ya'ud salam tabarakta wa ta'alayta ya dhal jalal wal ikram. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah grant peace of mind to each and every Muslim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cool the Muslim eyes of Muslimin with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brother and sister Islam, before the break I was talking about the message of Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq, that great person from Ahl al-Bayt, the descendants of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now when we talk about that stressful moment where the Muslim nowadays live in, your deen needs some demand, and then your dunya wants some demand, and your nafs wants some demand, shaitan needs something, your children need something. So you have so many things around you. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala brought us to this world as in a testing era. So it is ibtila from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already put for us the frame of peace. And he said, man bata, whosoever spend his night, aminam fi sirbih, secure and peacefully live in his sirbih. You know what is sirbih? Sirbih in Arabic words, that flock of pigeon. The birds, you know, they fly together. They got flocks, they tire on ababil, you know, groups. So what happened in this hadith, we learn that you cannot live lonely and alone. To live as an individual by yourself like that is impossible. You need relatives, you need wife, you need children, you need society, you need neighbors like this. How to get amn and security and safety fi sirbihi with the jama'ah. Man bata aminan fi sirbihi. When we talk about aman and safety, you get safety with yourself, the nafs. We were talking about it today. You already set up agreement with your nafs that, you know what, I will obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no way to take me away from the command of Allah. Peace with your relatives, family around you. Peace in society. Peace with Allah. Peace with Allah. Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, when his father did want to throw him on the fire and pelt him and what, he told him, Salamun alaik, peace be upon you, my father. It means peace from me to you. Sa'astaghfiru laka rabbi. I need another peace for you, my father, from Allah, because my peace is not enough. I want to save you even there in the day of judgment. So we need peace with ourselves so that we can get rid of that stress. Peace with our family and relatives, peace in society, and peace with Allah. That's why Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whosoever can obtain and gain that peace, aminan fi sirbih. But make sure that you have no error and problem with the people around you. At least from your side. Leave the other people's side. Right? Mu'afan fi badanih. Mu'afan fi badanih, it means healthy physically and psychologically. You know, we have some people are very healthy, but mentally they are not well. Or spiritually they are not well. Or in morality are not well. No, I need a proper health. Psychological health, physical health, and spiritual health. Mu'afan fi badanih. Because actually all that sickness come together. If you are mentally not well, you can't worship Allah. If you are psychologically not well, you can't take the taqdeer of Allah. So you need that collective health. Right? عِنْدَهُ قُوتَ يَوْمِهِ. He got the food of his day. The food of his day. It takes us to the level of birds. Birds is the only creation of Allah, got full tawakkul and rely on Allah, put full trust on Allah. Birds. That birds, every morning they fly. They don't know where they are going, from where they will collect the seed, and returning with the shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, feeding their children. So, عِنْدَهُ قُوتَ يَوْمِ. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he spoke about قُوت, the food, حَسْبُ بْنِ آدَمْ لُقَيْمَاتٍ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبًا. So it's sufficient for the son of Adam. Few bites, few loaf, few slices of bread, it will let him survive. Just to survive. نَحْنُ قَوْمٌ لَا نَأْكُلُ حَتَّى نَجُوعُ وَإِذَا أَكَلْنَا لَا نَشْبَعُ. That food, is not a desire, it's to survive. Many people nowadays, they spend so much money on the food. Why? Because it's not now the need, it's a want. They want to eat. And now you see now the takeaways and all the food, they try to put a flavor and recipe, so they make the people mad of that smell. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, few bites of bread or food just to survive and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عِنْدَهُ قُوتَ يَوْمِهِ. It means you are not hungry. You have the three meals. They call it عَيْشٌ كَفَافٌ. ذاق طعم الإسلام من رضي بالله ربا وكان عيشه كفافا. The fortunate person, the one who tasted the sweetness of Iman by that sufficient livelihood or the life standard, and his tasting the Iman of Allah, the one who accepted the Iman of Allah. So ذاق طعم الإيمان, the only one who tastes the Iman, the one who radiya billahi rabba, the one who accepted Allah as his God only, with no shirk. And وَكَانَ عَيْشُهُ كَفَافَ, it means his staple. كَفَافَ, it means it's okay. He does not need and he does not save. It's like عَيْشُهُ كَفَافَ. The other thing also, this is حَقِيقَةُ الدُّنْيَا. That is what you get. The food you eat, the clothes you wear, and your أعمال, what you get. The a'mal, what you get, and what you get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the reality of dunya. Dunya mata' wa ma dunya illa mata'u al-ghurur. So what is mata'? Mata', it means the necessity in your handbag for short journey. Mata'u al-rajul khasatuhu fi safarin qasir. The mata', it means that if you want to go for a holiday 1 or 2 days, what do you have in your handbag? You don't take the fridge and cupboard and lounge, put it there on a bag. You don't take the garden. You take one towel, toothbrush, and then a little bit of food there, and some necessity in the handbag. In dunya is a safarun qasir. But you see now the person lives 60 years, 30 years to make money, another 30 years to secure that money, and he die as an enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are not saying the people must not make money, but you have to know the reality of this dunya. The other thing, the most fortunate person, the one who leave this world with no hatred. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Your children, your wealth will never protect you from the punishment of Allah unless you meet Allah with a قلب سليم, with a pure heart. When you talk about health, the psychological health, spiritual health, and physical health, that one I was mentioned now. قلب سليم, it means you have no jealous, you have no malice, you're innocent child. You die with a pure and clean heart. What a nice mayyid that one. Brother and sister in Islam, you got so many brothers and sisters, they are full of hatred and envy and jealous. Do you want to change the taqdeer of Allah? Do you want to attack the people because Allah favored them and gave them some wealth and some health? Brother and sister in Islam, if you can control your nafs and purify your heart, you will be. The other thing which it's very important, the huquq al-ibad, the right of the others. Right of the others, when you oppress the others, when you do wrong to the others, you're causing a big problem for yourself and a big problem to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to give you shafa'at, intercession in a day of qiyamah. So what happened? What about if that person you oppressed him refused? So you will be suspended till that person give you that sorry or accept your apology and reconcile with you. We have hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That hadith is frightening us a lot. For those who die cheating or they are dishonest or took the right of the others without permission. وَمَنْ يَغْلُلْ يَأْتِي بِمَا غَلَّ بِهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Whosoever cheat and steal and rob the others, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call him with his crime in the day of Qiyamah, what he was cheating. Brother and sister in Islam, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا لَا أَعْرِفَنَّ أَحَدًا مِنْكُمْ. I will never recognize one of you. He means that he will never grant intercession, shafa'a, ahadam minkum, one of you, ya'ti yawm al-qiyama, will come to me in a day of qiyama, biba'ir, with a camel, or cow, or sheep, and some narration say, carry it, and he say, ya Muhammad, help, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا أغني عنكم من الله شيء. I cannot stand against Allah because Allah has overpowered me and you. Right? إني قد بلغت. Oh Allah, you are my witness. I have informed them. Do not die ظالم, taking the right of the others and claiming that Rasulullah ﷺ will come and approve that robbery to you in the day of Qiyamah and stand for you to defend you. Let us do favor for ourselves and favor to Rasulullah ﷺ to meet him clean so that he can stand and give us intercession and ask Allah to forgive us and take us to Jannatul Firdaus fi maq'ad sidqin 'inda malikin muqtadir. Rabbana inna sami'na munadiya yunadi lil iman an aminu bi rabbikum fa amanna. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. شكرا جزيلا. Till we see you إن شاء الله next time. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا. ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا. ربنا